حسين صياص شيخ الجزء من الوالدة الورولوجي سيرفيس مورتاليتيز فروم سيبسيس فيري هاي. And I started reading and reading the topic, and gradually I developed my own report. And a couple of years later, I used to tell my junior resident, you have to start treatment of sepsis before the patient goes into sepsis. And explain the tachycardia, and explain the volume in our foot. They trigger you to treat sepsis even if the patient doesn't have fever, doesn't have osteoporosis, or diseases. Things changed, and I grasped this opportunity to present to you the Hour One bundle presented by the Surviving Sepsis Campaign, which is joint collaboration between the Society of Critical Care Medicine and the European Society of Intensive Care Medicine. And the goal is to reduce the mortality and the morbidity from sepsis and the septic shock worldwide. They developed the guidelines, the Hour One bundle, and they aim to implement this bundle and these guidelines for 100% of sepsis and septic shock patients worldwide. And these guidelines are translated into six languages, other than the English language, one of them is Arabic language. And the slogan is screen every patient, every shift, every day. Okay? That we have to look for sepsis in every patient, every shift, and every day to prevent treatment as early as possible. And the core quality improvement is the bundle. The core one bundle is the bundle that should be implemented for sepsis and septic shock patients, considering sepsis and septic shock are medical emergencies. The specific intervention should start the first hour of sepsis recognition, even if the patient is in his way to the hospital. You may start treatment of sepsis while he's in the ambulance car. It's not necessary to finish everything in this first hour. So that is first hour bundled, not 1 hour bundled. Okay? And you don't want to finish everything in the first hour, but you have to start everything in the very first hour of diagnosis or suspecting sepsis or septic shock. The other one bundle that every one of us should be aware about is to measure lactate as a surrogate of the of tissue perfusion. And we measure it in 2 to 4 hours if the initial one is less than or more than 2 millimoles per liter. Second, to obtain a sample for blood culture before implementation of antibiotics. And then you start immediately suitable broad spectrum antibiotic. And if the patient develops hypotension or his lactate is more than 4 millimoles per liter, you have to start rapidly steroid infusion 30 milliliter per kilogram. If the patient doesn't respond to this, you may implement the vasopressors immediately in cases of possessive hypotension to maintain the mean arterial pressure more than 65 milliliter per. The Surviving Sepsis Campaign has a lot of resources. One of them is a pocket card that every one of us may carry in his pocket to remind him about the initial steps he should take in patients diagnosed or expected to have sepsis. One of them is this one, another one is this one, that reminds everyone about the bundle, 1 hour bundle procedures. We have the manual. This manual has these topics. One of them next to the role and the physician roles, so that everyone in this room has its own role in our one body. We have developed guidelines. The guidelines are like ours in neurology and also in nephrology. These guidelines give best practice statements. Every guideline has its own level of evidence and level of recommendation. So that one of them is like this. Sepsis and septic shock are medical emergencies. We recommend that treatment and resuscitation begins immediately. This is best. best practice statement. Example of guideline, they recommend the administration of intravenous antimicrobial be initiated as soon as possible after the recognition and within 1 hour of both sepsis and septic shock. The level of evidence is moderate quality, and that depends on the scientific research in the field, and the recommendation is a stronger recommendation. You have to implement this. Another guideline, they suggest against use of corticosteroids in sepsis and septic shock, unless as long as level resuscitation and vasopressin therapies are capable of maintaining blood pressure, and if not achievable, they suggest intravenous hydrocortisone at the dose of 200 mg per day. However, the scientific evidence is of low quality, like one paper of the couple of papers, and the recommendation is weak. Okay? So that they give you the guideline with its level of evidence and degree of recommendation. Very useful. And the guidelines cover different topics. One of them is mechanical ventilation, glucose control, renal replacement, nutrition, etc. So that the kind of formula will be very simple and very short mind. So that surviving sepsis campaign guidelines and the bundle are important resources for practicing physicians, awareness, patient screening, and implementation to improve patient health and survival. So that these screen every patient, every shift, every day. Thank you very much.